What is up, guys? Back with another fourth episode of the Death walkthrough. So it's been a long time, I know. Don't really know why I left a mark here the last time, but today we continue the walkthrough. So last we left off, we finished Triton Avenue with the whole that suspicious can't even remember his name. Harvest Lord? Yeah. So here are the stats. Level 8, 15 damage, 12 resist, 3 accuracy. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Everything else is the same. Veil, Howling, Foot Gear, same, Scythe, Heart Steel, Flaw, just using some random ring. This is the pet. Tanglewood. Yeah. So last we left off, we were going into Firecat because it's easier than Cyclops, so it's better if we just at least level up here once before we go into Cyclops. So we'll do this. The story. We kind of have to save some fire elves, I think. But yeah, here's the first look of a Firecat Alley. Looks nice. I remember I was so hyped when I first played this game, and I was like, this looks amazing. So yeah, let's get into this.
Hey, you there! Could you give an old soldier a hand? I'm Private Quinn. I was planning to meet some fire elf friends here, but they didn't show up. They like to have their fun with me sometimes, but with all that's happening, would you check on them for me? Head over to Fire Globe Theater, where they live, and see if they're all right. I'll wait here in case they arrive before you do.
All right. What kind of spells we got going on here? Five, six, seven. Okay, I was smart enough to do that then. All right. So we got those spells going on. I actually can't wait to get back into doing this death walkthrough. It's been kind of a really long time, and death is actually one of my favorite skulls. I do have a 110 death. Probably when I started this walkthrough, I probably never even had a death, but I did end up making another one and got it to 110. And it's actually been one of my favorite schools. And this death is, it's definitely in for the long run because we got so much to go through. We're level 8 though, so we're almost done with, Wizard City, so it's pretty good. We're gonna finish Firecat Alley here today, though. I don't know if that's rushing it or anything, but
you're back. Let me guess. They were playing a prank on me.
Private Quinn falls ashen when you tell him about the fire elves.
Oh no, that's no prank. You don't know them like I do. Something horrible must have happened to the fire elves. Once, a fire elf saved my life with an arrow. His name was Phoebo.
Phoebo.
He said we'd be friends forever because their magic connects everything they touch.
Sounds like a storybook. Are you sure you're not getting this from, like, an Avalonian type book?
That's it. Bring me their arrows and we can find out what happened to them. You'll have to duel a few of them first.
Four arrows. That's not going to be easy. Wow. This is a great way to start off the episode, isn't it? So I guess I'll be back when I'm done collecting all of these. gonna lie, took a little bit. One of the battles I actually crit on one of the mobs because my handy dandy vengeance pet came through. It's pretty funny. Alright, talk to Pirate Quinn now.
Great! Thanks for doing this for the Fire Elves.
No problem.
If the Fire Elves are cursed or enchanted, and I'd bet my life they are, this arrow should reveal who did it. Greta Darkkettle used to teach alchemy at the school. She might help if you bring her the arrow.
Oh gosh, here we go. The charred knife quest. This is gonna be a disaster. What is that on my hat? I never even knew what that symbol was. If you guys are wondering what I'm wearing the rocking outfit stitch from the Kraken quest. Yeah. One day we'll be able to go up the stairs.
So, you found me. What do you want? You can tell that Ambrose I'm not coming back.
You explain the curse upon the Fire Elves. Greta takes the arrow you brought, then chuckles.
He's a good soul, that Quinn, but what he knows about magic, you probably learned your first day. I need more than this. To find out who cursed the Fire Elves, I'll need a charred knife from one of those Magna men roaming the street. I'll be waiting.
I'm pretty sure she actually ends up turning bad way later in the game. Overall, like way later. But for right now, she's evil. She's still evil because these magma men, I tell you. We're gonna try to get it though on camera, so go on. With our awesome scythe and everything. So it looks like I'll be able to kill them with a blade ghoul. I also noticed alright, I actually had a cut there, someone walked in the room, sorry about that, but I finally collected it. It took me six battles. Greta, let's see what you have to say.
You got the charred knife?
I did.
Excellent. This'll show the school I know what I'm doing.
Yeah, we get it. You want revenge.
Greta sprinkles magic dust on the charred knife and arrow.
Aha! The Fire Elves have been cursed by a banshee's wail. All you need is a lock of her hair. Talk to Private Quinn. He could prove useful. He may know of a banshee lurking nearby.
Alright, so we have to go talk to Private Quinn. He's gonna have us kill the banshee. After that, if I'm not mistaken, collect 6 arrows. I think. No. Never mind. It's not a collect. I was wrong. Defeat 6 elves. And then we get to defeat the final boss. So we're almost done with the fire cat here.
Banshee's wail. That sounds like a wicked curse. Good thing you convinced Greta to help. I've received reports that a banshee is up to no good. I know who it is, too. Bastila Gravewind haunts the last tower at the very end of Firecat Alley.
Of course it's at the very end.
Defeat her in battle and snip a lock of hair from her wicked head. Greta needs that hair to save the elves.
What if it was a percent chance to drop? How messed up would that be? So we're going to mark here this time. You know, you would think that he would sense that witch there, but he doesn't. And there is a witch there because I've done the side quest. I think you get it from him. So we have to walk all the way the heck over here. This is painful. So as we do this, we can pick up some wooden chests, also, I don't know what I was going to talk about during when I cut. Oh. One of the magma men did like max fire cat on me. It was pretty horrible. I think it was just there to warn me about the sigil. And it was pretty horrible because it did like 2-something, which makes no sense. Because...
So, you are the one who has been undoing my work. The Fire Elves were to remain cursed until Wizard City was in ruins. Your meddling in Malastare's plans will cost you dearly, Wizard. I shall send you back to Ravenwood as an example of what happens to those who oppose us.
Gosh, you have to pay attention to these details. What is this? 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. She only has 4 eyelashes on this eye. But I guess it is because it's smaller. So we got a boss here. We'll cheat and put a banshee in. Got 3 of those. I doubt we need a hex. Could put a heal in or so. She has like 200 health. There's no way I need more than that. 4, okay. We're gonna keep that just for safekeeping. Don't need that. Let's use... Yeah, let's use our blade. I was hoping he would do nothing. I can't afford getting hit right now. We'll use our other blade. Coming from... I can't even remember her name. Whiskers. Coming from Whiskers. Prince Duncan. That's an that's unacceptable. Pass. Oh. See, now we've run into a problem. She's deaf. I just noticed that. We might actually have to flee and come back here. Yeah, this is not good. When do I actually get my death prisms? What I'm wondering now. Does she even resist? She does. Okay. Well, that was horrible. Could we still win? I say why not? We'll get rid of little fire elf here. If it does max, please do max. That's horrible. Well, this could be GG for me. If they both don't attack, I might be fine. Might. So she attacked. That kills. That does kill me. That's my 12 resist, so sidestep. Nope. So we did die. That was horrible. That was my mistake.
Oh, don't! And if you need, you can also try and catch some wisps to regain your health or mana.
Have prism. But where do I get my prism? I honestly can't remember when Death gets their prism. Is there something I missed? I don't get it. So we don't have a prism yet. We're gonna have to go for some of these. Can use that. This is definitely weird. How? I just don't get. Alright, well, I'm gonna go back, do the battle, and I'm gonna go try this again. I'll see you when I get there. Okay, I think we're gonna take a different approach here. What I'm gonna do is, so I got my Deathblade on. I'm gonna ghoul, get my health back, and kill him in the process. Then I'll pet blade, I'll do my hex, and then I'll hit with fire oath. It seems like the best kind of strategy to do here. So yeah, got blood back, got that. So we'll do we'll do a blade storm. And by the way, I literally walked all the way back. I did not realize that there is a recall. Wow. It was horrible. I mean, it wasn't too bad. I just had to walk from where Private Quinn was. So now I got my crit bubble up too, so crit this fire elf? No. So that's gonna do absolutely mass over time. So 1, 2, 3. Yeah, she should be dead. Cause it still has 2 more to go, so that's about 220. I think one of these should do the trick. It's funny how everything works out. So yeah, that was the strategy I decided to go with now. So, all you death wizards out there, this is the video for you. Just, I'm pretty sure not many death, have this pet, but if you do, at least get the hex. I think that's what it is, a hex curse. Where am I getting it from? Yes, at least get the hex amulet. I'm pretty sure they should have one. You should definitely get that hex amulet. And then for me, I was just lucky I had the thing. Or you can just use spells, try to get lucky. I actually have to go all the way back to Greta. Okay. Weird app today. I actually don't recall some of this or most of this. Going back to Greta this time. Thought we'd have to go back to Private Quinn, but I guess not yet. Get our level up here from Greta. Show me the level up, Greta.
You have a lock of the Banshee's hair. After this, Ambrose should believe what I've been telling him about the Death School.
Greta burns the lock of hair over a white candle, and then hands the melted wax to you.
Done. Tell Private Quinn that the wax from this candle can break the curse on his precious fire elves.
All right. Nope, we're getting our level up from Private Quinn, which is what I wanted. Private Quinn actually seems reasonable. Sorry, Greta. You seem pretty shady, sketchy. Boom. Private Quinn.
You have a cure? Great news!
Yes, that's great news. You're about to send me to defeat a lot of people, though, so it's bad news.
I've taken the wax from the candle and mixed it into the potion. I hope I did it right. You'd better do the rest. Defeat the Fire Elves and their leader, Prince Alakane Swift Arrow. The potion should then break the curse. Good luck, wizard.
All right. That is a quest. So we are level 9, which is really good, but we... I'd say we'll be halfway done with Wizard City by the time we finish Cyclops. Yeah, because we still got Crab Alley to do. I'm not for sure if you want me to... You know, I'll go ahead and skip these battles. Just because I want to try to fit Cyclops up in here, so... Yeah, I'll see you guys when I'm done defeating these 6. Alright, so we got that done with. Time to go defeat Alakane Swift Arrow. Up in the fire. Glow Theater. I knew there would be a chest here, but the Smith. Smith is over here for you guys who... didn't know. So that's their fire cat. We're gonna go ahead. Actually, is our deck pretty good?
Don't you know it's rude to interrupt a performance? But you are just in time, wizard. This is your final act.
Ha. Okay. So, I remember he has actually quite a bit of health, so we're gonna put in some extra hits. Can't be too safe. Heal. Seems good. We'll put another hex. We can get that Magma Man over with one. Yeah. I think we're good. He has like 6. He used to have like... Well, yeah. I know he used to have like 600 health or something like that. Back in the days. At least we're actually going against not a death boss when we don't even have our prison yet. Alright, we'll just heal that back. And kill him in the process. This is what I like about Death Wizards. You can kill pretty easy. And heal back. And we got a crit aura up. Wow. Looks like Alakane isn't gonna have that much of a great time. We can't hex him. Yeah, let's do that. Hmm. See, that still does a decent amount. So what I want to do actually is I don't want to attack or Bladestorm. I want to pass and then Banshee into a ghoul. I mean, into a fairy or a sprite, whatever. So Banshee into a sprite. I think he should be dead. Or he might just die by this. Who knows? Okay, yeah. Banshee into a dark sprite. And that'll be a GG. That's gonna do a ton. Wow. Fire bosses are not to be messed with. Can I get that crit? And GG Alakane. That was a nice meeting you, knowing you. Level me up.
As you pour the potion into his mouth, Alakane's swift arrow shivers and his maddened eyes soften.
Good.
I remember. I was cursed, as were all my people. Did Private Quinn send you? Tell him his arrow saved me, as mine once did him. The curse. I can feel the effects of the curse weakening. Now that we know it was the Banshee's curse, we will guard against it. Tell Private Quinn that we owe him a debt of gratitude. And thanks to you, Wizard, for freeing all of us.
No problem. That was, I liked Firecat Alley. It actually made sense with the story and all on the alley. Of course, the story with Wizard City as a whole doesn't really tie in together. You're kind of just helping all the streets, but I guess that's always good. I think Crab Alley will be the final street in our case, though. I think you have to be like a level 11.
Thank you for freeing Prince Swift Arrow. Your deeds here will long be remembered by the elves.
That voice, though. Where is he? Am I sitting on him? Gosh. He's just, like, entangled into my roots. That probably hurts.
I'm glad to see the elves again, even if they are a bit annoying.
They are really annoying.
No, I never thought the curse would win, even for a moment. Still, I'm glad you helped my friend, Prince Alakane. Firecat Alley is much too dangerous, Wizard. Someone needs to warn the Headmaster. Please go tell Headmaster Ambrose about the curse upon the Fire Elves. I will stay here and warn the others.
Alright. That was eventful. So let's go talk to Headmaster Ambrose then. Turn it in, and then we can start, Cyclops. What is this? Is this about the chat?
Say, yeah. The mess. Words that are valid will show up white. Words that are not allowed by the filter will show up red. For more details, go to the Wizard One.
Huh? Ah, it's my favorite student.
Favorite?
I hear you've been exploring the different streets around the city.
The headmaster listens intently as you tell him about the events of Firecat Alley.
I was afraid of this. Malastare is trying to keep us from finding out his real plans by causing chaos and panic on every street. We must find out what he is up to for the safety of our school.
Well, that zoom.
I will have to think on this some more. He has found many creatures to help do his bidding. I fear that he has sinister designs, not only for our world, but for all the others as well. You have done quite well, young wizard. I am proud of you. Keep up the good work. I want you to introduce yourself to Diego, the duel master. He manages the arena. The arena is just inside the entrance to Unicorn Way,
well,
on the
I
right.
Have to accept them no matter what. Wait.
Congratulations. You click. If you're high enough level, you can buy a personal house from the castle shop in the Wizard City shopping district. Talk to Buxley.
Stormgate.
He'll show you what's available.
It is time that we go and rescue Cyclops Lane from its so-called troubles. We're almost level 10, actually. More than halfway. and then we'll get our new spell, which is Banshee. I'm hoping Prism is somewhere in between those guidelines, because we clearly need it. Maybe not for Cyclops, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna need it sometime along for like the last boss of Wizard101. I mean, yeah, Wizard City. I'm pretty sure he's death. Still got Colossus Boulevard to go too. But jeez, there's a lot of Wizard City to do.
What are you doing here? Only talented wizards like me should be out on these dangerous streets.
You're very cocky, Nolan.
Think you have what it takes? This place needs real heroes. We'll see if you can make the grade.
Alright.
Let's see how useful you are. Professor Drake put me in charge of a very important mission. Magical artifacts from the old Death School have resurfaced. I've decided you're going to recover the one inside the spooky dark cave. Every other student I've asked has been too afraid to go, so I'm hoping for better from you. Battle everything in the dark cave until you find the ruined skull.
Alright. So this is a horrible, 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 horrible drop rate. I do not think you guys want to see this, so... gonna have to catch you later on this one. So yeah, I see you guys. I finally collected it. Took about five battles. Yeah, five battles. Wasn't as bad as the charred knife one, gosh. But I remember being there once for like 20 battles straight, just trying to get that skull.
You found the rune skull?
Yes, I did.
Huh. Faster than I could have imagined. Professor Drake will be pleased with me.
Pretty fast.
I told a few students to pick up death relics up the street. Now they're nowhere to be found. No doubt gabbing instead of working. Huh. Can you look after the students on the slim, slim chance that something's happened to them? I'd start with the trolls. They look shifty.
Alright, so this one I can actually put in because... it seems like this one isn't really that bad. So, of course, I have my average kind of deal going on here. Blade, ghoul, blade, ghoul. I'm a deathcaster. Is the best death wizard. Soon to be the best death wizard. Wow. Messed up. Gonna need some mana pretty soon. GG. My pet always does this. Did not collect.
Oh, remember to go to the fairgrounds in the commons area and step on one of the sigils to play one.
As I say, I don't think any type of mob right now uses Tower Shield. I was about to get salty. Tower Shield is a level 16 spell anyways. There's no way we should be seeing that until like Marleybone. He really likes ice spells. He wants to be an ice troll. Or a little frost troll. That's what he wants to be. Rank 1. We're still fighting rank 1s, guys. This is horrible. Alright. We collected it. See, it wasn't that bad. Talk to Nolan here. Find out about the missing students.
What is this? A letter? How odd. Trolls can't read. Maybe by the handwriting, a Cyclops
maybe
wrote this. They
could
never
read.
Dot their I's. It's addressed to M, whoever that is. I should take a look at it if students are in danger. Great fire bats! The Cyclops have kidnapped the students! Oh, good thing you found this. We must act immediately. I hope they're not gonna blame me for those students getting themselves kidnapped. I know. I'll inform Professor Drake at once. He'll know what to do. When I tell him how those students got themselves kidnapped while I was... On second thought, I think you should go tell him. I'll stay here and keep an eye on those Cyclops.
You're disgusting. You're a disgusting human being. So, we're gonna have to go talk to Cyrus. Get in trouble. For this loser. As we collect some wisps. So I guess it's gonna work out either way, because it's not like Cyrus is our teacher.
What
anyways.
Do you want?
Professor Drake sneers at the ransom note.
Sneers.
Here. Take this message to Victor Darkwood, the robe shopkeeper. Be quick about it. Time is of the essence here.
You know, I'm thinking that this, this is a... Either it's Drake that's only in on it, and the guy was, You know what? No, because he sends us to go help the students anyways. So, it is just Drake who's like, I'm gonna read this, not care about it, but remember that I have clothes at the shop, so maybe while this person's here, I can go have them fetch it for me and tell them it's of the time is of the essence.
Ah, a message from Professor Drake. Yes, I've been expecting you. You'll need to hurry back with this.
The shopkeeper retrieves a large sack and hands it to you.
Here you go. Professor Drake's laundry, freshly cleaned and pressed. And don't let it drag on the pavement now.
Wow. I didn't see that coming when I first played this game. Seriously, laundry? I thought the large sack was like something to help us. I should have known though, it was a rope shop.
That certainly took you long enough.
Well gosh, it took me like 2 seconds.
Professor Drake shakes his head at you.
You're still worried about those missing students? Yes, well, this is definitely a problem. Take this message to the headmaster. That should resolve things to my satisfaction.
Alright. Because only the headmaster would care to listen to what's going on. That is why he's headmaster. And not you. Precisely why.
Ah, young wizard, it's good to see you. You have a note for me. Let's see it.
The headmaster reads Professor Drake's note.
I will not expel you from the Ravenwood School of Magical Arts, regardless of what Professor Drake thinks of you. You are not responsible for the problems on Cyclops Lane. General Achilles and his men promised to drive out the trolls. Now, Achilles has gone back on his word.
That's true.
I fear there is something more sinister behind Achilles' change of heart. This M is to blame. We will need to know more. Drake is of no use here, but you have been most helpful. Go back to Nolan Stormgate and help him straighten this out.
And the M stands for Malastare, I'm pretty sure. Pretty dang sure. If it's not, then... we'll butter my butt and call me a biscuit. I should have actually left a mark, but I didn't. It was horrible. But we had wisps on the way, so I guess it worked out, because we have 32 mana now, back to our full potential to slay things. Can I cross the street here safely? Thank you. Nolan, tell me what I have to do next, because obviously I've never played this game before and I have no clue what to do.
Well, I wasn't expecting Professor
Your
Drake to leave everything
awful,
to us.
By the way.
He must really trust me. Professor Drake is expecting big things. The Cyclops General Achilles wrote the note, so we need to reach his keep. But to do that, we need a gate pass. Maybe, can you steal one from the Warhorns? All you have to do is defeat some. Yeah, that should be easy enough.
Alright, so this one isn't too bad. I'm glad we got Firecat actually done before Cyclops, because Firecat is definitely easier, but kind of a struggle because of how many mobs you defeat. In Cyclops' story, you don't really defeat too much. You just gotta collect one, and I think it's just been, collect ones. And not that bad as Firecat, where collect four, defeat six, collect a knife, defeat a boss. Horrible. Ooh. Blade with goal actually won't kill anymore, so we're gonna have to take an extra round to blade up once more. And then we can attack. Cool. GG. At least I think. That has to do more than 280. Yeah, definitely. So that's GG. We're gonna have to do that. We did not collect it. How we keep going until we collect it. Warhorn. Kinda disturbed by the name. That axe though. If you guys didn't know, because I play pirate, obviously. That axe in Pirate is actually pretty freaking good. Not gonna lie, it's actually really good. I'm currently trying to farm it on my Buccaneer, but it's kind of a struggle. Well, not kind of a struggle, it is a struggle. Even hitting the chest is probably not worth it. So after Cyclops, I'm trying to think about what we have to do next. We'll be level 11, so we can do Colossus Boulevard. Just get us to level 12, then we can do Crab Alley. And then we can go on with the storyline. We collected it. Nice. Go back to Nolan. What's the good stuff?
You got the pass! Great job! I'm glad I thought of that. With your magic and my brains, we make an unstoppable team.
Alright.
Okay, here's my plan. Show your pass to the guard, Romulus, outside the keep at the end of the street, and he'll let you in. He's not too bright. Then you must challenge General Achilles in combat. Cyclopses are honor-bound. According to the Cyclops Code of Honor, he can't refuse to fight you. See where I'm going? Even if someone is telling Achilles to hold the students hostage, once you defeat him in battle, he will be honor-bound to free them. All you have to do is beat him.
Alright, so, final, battle in this, episode here. And this is actually the final street, which is, pretty nice. These three streets are the big struggle of Wizard City, apparently, and we're about to get that done today. And yeah, this has all been done solo, so all you death wizards that want to make a death and you're doing it straight from the beginning, you can kind of use my videos as a guide of how I did it and stuff. Of course, I don't know if you guys are going to be exactly like what I have, you know, the stats and all. Almost got pulled.
Well, you don't look like a warhorn to me. But, this pass looks good, so I guess you could go in.
So he's dumb right now, but once we start the Aquila games, he's actually pretty smart. He knows his stuff. So he probably gets edumacated just a little bit the next time we encounter this individual.
You hear a girl's voice off to your left.
Of course.
Help us, please! We're held here by General Achilles!
What? You are here to rescue these students? That I cannot allow! I am honor-bound to keep them until I'm told otherwise. But if you were to defeat me, I would be honor-bound to free them for you. If you want their freedom, you will have to fight me for it. And mind you, as general, I will put up a good fight.
You know, this sends a bad message to generals because you're obviously gonna die a horrible, painful death. Deceased. Horrible. Painful. Death. Come on. Seriously, you guys gotta stop using ice spells. Because you guys scare me. Every single time with that. I don't know what it is. Whenever I see ice, I just get paranoid and I'm like, wow. Really? We're gonna take a different approach to this boss. We're actually gonna kill the boss first. They actually do mass damage even though I have 12 resist. And 12 resist is at least 12 resist or above 10 is pretty good for level 10. So I don't understand how they do so much damage to him. Ice Beetle. I think I should survive the next round. This should kill him. I do have a stronger one though, so do that. Fizzle, yes. That is a Storm Snake. Or Thunder Snake. I should be getting a lot of health back from this. Is really that crit though? The clutch crit. Wow. That clutch crit. There are some miracles going on today. Today is a miracle day. It is a miracle day. Wow. I did not see that coming. You know what? That probably honestly would have not killed him. I didn't do the math, but that probably would have not killed him if I didn't crit. Praise. See, that's how I know my resist is working. Wow. Another crit. A miracle day, guys. Miracle day.
You have defeated me, brave wizard. So I must honor your request to free the students. My master will be angry that I let them go, but I must obey the Cyclops' code of honor. Go now. They are free.
Go to kids being held.
Thank you for freeing us. We were starting to believe that no one was coming to help us.
Thank goodness you showed up. No telling who would have come to rescue us.
Oh, they all
thought at least Professor Drake would have come looking for us, but he didn't. Thank you for coming to our aid.
Well, time to go back to Nolan Stormgate and wrap this up. Might actually just go talk to Diego Santiago Cortez. Is that it? Yeah. No, that's not Cortez. That's Corquiez, something like that. But, talk to him just to see what he wants. Since it is mandatory. And I should be leveling up right now. So we could put that ring on. And we can get more health. I think we have other stuff to put on too. Not sure. Wooden chest. Nolan! We did it. We did it. We did it.
Let me get this straight. The Cyclops were holding the students hostage in order to bring chaos to Wizard City?
Yes.
But who would make General Achilles do such a thing?
A Malastare.
I'm sure Professor Drake could figure out who's behind this mess if he wanted to. Too bad he's always so busy.
Yep.
We should tell the headmaster how we saved the students, especially my plan to sneak you inside the keep. Still, I have to find those artifacts for Professor Drake. After what happened, I shouldn't let anyone else do it. Would you go tell the headmaster what happened? Tell him how you were able to save them due to my brilliant planning. I'm sure he'll reward us both.
Great.
Your training has paid off. I could teach you a new spell now. Come.
Wizard, I hear you have reached level 10. Come to me when you would like to learn about tournaments.
Alright, so we'll go talk to Ambrose. Actually, let's equip. Oh, I didn't see. I don't know why I thought we were a myth. But yeah, we can equip this one. We love our heart steel. We love our boots. We love our robe. And we love our hat. Really have nothing else. Got more mana though, so that's always good.
Quite a daring rescue. I'm glad that you were able to save the students. It bothers me that someone could force General Achilles into a sinister plot against Wizard City. I suspect that M is Malastare himself.
No way.
It seems obvious that this is another of Malastare's plans to throw us off his trail. With all the wizards busy here in Wizard City, Malastare feels free to carry out his ultimate plans. Hopefully, we can catch up with him before then. Keep up the good work. Nolan seems to have warmed to you. Perhaps Professor Drake isn't far behind.
So, Colossal Trouble.
I have a very important task for you today, young wizard. Your studies will have to wait. You've done such a great job elsewhere. I could use your magic on Colossus Boulevard. I had to lock the gate because the street had become too dangerous. Professor Greyrose summoned an army to run out the ghosts. Something must have gone very wrong with her spell. The gate guard, Private O'Doyle, can tell you more. Please find him in the shopping district and see if he needs help. I know. We need this key, young wizard. Go defeat Foulgaze and bring it to
so
me.
That's the main quest.
Then we will be able to uncover who is working for Malastare.
We're going to talk to Diego, though, so we can get that off of my quest list. Just real quick. So yeah, Colossus Boulevard, next episode. What is it? Oh, we're going to get our spell right now, too. Alright, so Diego.
Greetings!
I'm pretty sure that's just about all that stuff. I just want to get this quest off of my quest log. I'm pretty sure it's just all about the PvP and whatnot and stuff and stuff. I never really talked to him.
Diego, thank you. The only thing he loved. Speaking of issues concerning Malastare, one of his favorite students, a boy named Duncan Grimwater, has been tackling a ghost problem over on Triton
That's
Avenue.
What we're gonna be doing next episode. Get our spell in. That will be the end of this video. Banshee. And level 10. So this is actually the appropriate level that you should be leaving Wizard City, but I think we'll be leaving around level 15 or so, because Colossus will definitely level us to like 12 or 11, and then Crab Alley's pretty long. Okay, Dream Shield. Banshee. There we go. I got our Banshee here. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this episode today. Back doing the walkthrough. And so yeah, you guys have a great Sunday, because it is like 1:30 in the morning, so it's technically Sunday. And see y'all then.